Jay Holiday.
That's what a real mob do.
So starting off, as always, I am concealing my eyes using this LA Girl Pro Concealer in the shade Medium Beige. Now today I'm using Medium Beige to conceal my eyes because I'm going for a dramatic eye look and I want my colors on my lid to pop. And I am doing so using this Real Technique Dark Spot Correcting Brush. This is the best brush to use to buffer out your concealer around your eyelids to give you a nice smooth canvas. To set our lids, we're going to be setting them using this Milani Translucent Powder for medium deep skin tones. Now we're going to be highlighting our brow bone using this MAC Pigment Blondes Gold. So we're just popping that pigment right in the arch of our brow just to pop our brow bone, starting in the center and sweeping that pigment down to the tail part of our brow. And you want to do the same exact thing to the other eye. Now we're going inside of our Zulu palette by Juvia's Place, and we're going to be taking this mustard yellow shade for our first transition shade. For my transitions, before cutting my crease, I tend to like to do a sunset transition effect. So I either start off with a yellow, a red, or orange, something that's going to give you a sunset type transition. I am using to put down this shadow is from Real Technique, and it is a base shadow brush. When putting down my transitions and blending my shadows, I start from the outer corner of my eye, creating circular motions, going in towards the center to the inner part of the eye, just sweeping and blending back and forth, back and forth. And you want to make sure that you're doing the same exact methods to the other eye. Circular motions build up pigment of your shadow, and windshield wiper motions, they blend out. For our second transition, we're going inside of my favorite palette, which is the Urban Decay Naked Heat palette. I love this palette for all transition shades. We're going in and we're taking this light orange shade and we're just popping that right underneath that yellow shade, like above our crease area, and we're just taking that and we're just blending that over the top. And for my transition shades, I tend to like to add either two or three transitions. Today, I'm going to be adding three transitions. So, yeah. But you want to make sure that you're doing the same exact thing that you did to the first eye to the second eye. Don't necessarily right away worry about blending, because as we lay down our transitions with different colors, we're going to be going back in and blending out that previous shadow. So, in other words, once we lay down this orange, we're going to be going back in and we're going to be blending out that shadow with our Zulu palette mustard yellow shadow. So we're going to always go back in and alternate shadows to blend out each shadow every time that you lay a pigment down. So like right here, we're going in and we're blending out those corners of that orange shadow so that they don't look so harsh, so that our gradient actually look like it's going into a nice smooth effect. Now for our corners, we're going inside and we're picking up this red shade from this Nega Heat palette, and we're popping that right in the outer corner of our eyelid, and we're going to just sweep that in to the crease. Lately, I've been liking doing this sweeping in method. So I'll just roll my fluffy blending brush. This brush is from Morphe, part of the iSlate collection. I'll just roll that brush from the outer corner inward. And I notice that from the inner corner of my eye, it tends to soften it a bit more instead of looking so harsh and dramatic on the inner corner. Even though I still always go for a dramatic eye, but for my transitions, it tends to fade it out and blend it more nicely. Y'all, these transitions is popping. They fat. But I'm telling you, this Urban Decay Naked Heat palette is my go-to transition palette. Either that or the Zulu or the Saharan 2 palette. I go through all three of those palettes to pop out the most bombish transitions. Now for the dramatic part, we're going inside of our Magic palette by Juvia's Place, and we are snatching out this navy blue shade. Is called Yajetti, and we're just popping that right into our crease. So this is the trick when doing dramatic cut creases or any dramatic eyeshadow look. You want to make sure that you're blending out your darker shade. You always want, especially if you're doing something that almost looks black, even though this is navy blue, you want to make sure that you're blending that shadow. So once we put down this here pigment, we're going to be going in and we're going to be blending this shadow out using the previous shadow that we used, which was that red orange shadow from our Nega Heat palette. So that's the key to blending, y'all. Always go back and use the previous shade that you use to blend out any corners of your shadow so that you can't see no lines of demarcations, and so that everything is flawless. You want to continue to blend until your hand hurt. You want to blend back and forth, 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 until you can't go back, forth and forth no more. So we're cutting our crease using this NYX Vivid Bright Cream Color. You can use this as a shadow base. You can use it for an eyeliner. This product is very creamy, so I decided that I was going to use it today to cut my crease. because it gives me the nice precision and consistency that I need for cutting my crease. And the shade of this here cream, this color cream, Vivid Bright, is called Aqua Sapphire. Our first lid shadow we're popping in from the Urban Decay Shadow Box collection. This shade is called Moon Shadow, and it is a blue shade. For our second lid color, we're going inside of the Juvia's Place Masquerade palette, and we are picking up Zola. Now, Zola is a teal shimmer shadow, and we're just blending that into the corners of our shadow box shadow, Moon Shadow. This shadow right into the center part of our lid. For our inner corner lid shadow, I'm going inside of the Zulu palette, and I'm picking out this matte, it's like a mint green, teal greenish shade, and I'm just popping that right on the inner corner of our eye. Using this Formless Physician eyeliner. This is my favorite eyeliner. So we're going to be adding some glitter to this cut crease, and the glitters that I'm going to be using today are from Glitter Glamour. These are some very nice holographic glitters, by the way. I did a haul with Glitter Glamour, and I believe I got like 48 glitters in the haul. I'll talk about that in another video. I've been meaning to do the video. I just haven't gotten around to it. So yeah, so this glitter that I am placing on the middle part of my lid, or should I say center part of my lid, is called Aqua. And the glitter that I will be applying on the inner corner of my lid is called Teal. They are very similar in color. One glitter is just darker than the other. For my foundation, I'm using this Fenty Beauty foundation in the shade 450. I've been in love lately with using this brush to apply my foundation. I forget the brand of this brush, but I picked these brushes up. I have like three of them. They're for contouring, and I got them from TJ Maxx, just miscellaneous shopping as always. So anyway, I'm just taking this foundation and I'm just buffering it all through my face. And what I like most about this here brush is that I can get around my brows and all those nooks and crannies around my eyes without messing up any eye makeup or anything like that. And you want to make sure that you're getting that neck. You want to make sure that neck is blended. You want your neck and your face to blend. Just powdering our face out using this Ruby Kisses mineral powder and and we're just setting our highlighted areas, or should I say my contoured areas, using my favorite product, this Milani face setting powder. And I'm just highlighting my cheek area, my chin, my nose, my forehead. I'm going to be highlighting ourselves today using the Nicole Guerrero's Glow Kit. And the highlighters that I am using are 143 and Daydreamer. And I'm doing so on this BH Cosmetic fan brush. This brush is a part of the Smoke and Mirror collection. Now we're going to be adding our blush, and our blush is from the Saharan Blush Palette Volume 2. The name of this blush is called Sola. And for my favorite part, we're going to be going in and chiseling out our cheekbones and just defining our cheek area and those features in your face that you want to bring forward. And I am doing so darkening up my cheekbone area using Abby from the Saharan Blush Palette Volume 1. So today for our lip, we are going for ombre lip. So I am starting off lining my lip using this Rimmel London Lip Pencil in the color, or should I say in the shade, Spice. when I do an ombre lip, I shade in the corners of my lip. I don't know why, but I think it makes your lips appear more smaller, maybe. Who knows? So now I'm going to be going in and I'm going to be using this MAC. What is it by MAC? It's called Retro Matte Liquid Lip Color in the shade Divine. MAC Divine is actually a very pretty pink shade. I love it. It reminds me of Nicki Minaj or Barbie Pink. You know, some people say that brown girls can't wear light lip colors. I've heard it like dark complected, me's and you's. They say that, but I don't believe so. I believe that if you have the perfect lip liner to shade it out, or should I say shade it in, then you can make any color look good on your skin. And it's popping. So now we're just feathering out that lip liner a bit more. Just because I went outside of my lip line a little bit with this pink. But there's always tips and tricks to fix it so that this color can fit your skin tone. So now we're going in with this Laura Gallagher. It's a lip gloss with like glitter in it. I don't have it in front of me, but I will put it in the link in the description bar below to give me a little bit of gloss and a glittery lip look. So I did some accessory shopping last weekend and I picked up these earrings. They have a key with a crown on top of them. And I'm telling you, these earrings are bomb ass. Yes. So I thought it inspired something like Tiffany & Company or, you know, something. So I also got this earpiece. And, you know, I always got to do the most, okay? When it comes to accessories, I love accessories. Anything that's blinged out, got stones in it, okay? So, this ear clip right here, I was like, this is bomb. I'm going to just put this on. But I didn't keep it on throughout the video. So, now I'm going to go in and show you guys how to do like a, what could you call it, an evening style or a bun that you could wear either for prom, for elegant event, Grammys, red carpet, whatever. So I'm pulling his hair back into a ponytail and I'm twisting it just like you would do a fashion scarf. And you're just going to keep twisting it and twisting it and twisting it until you've twisted all the way down. And then you're going to wrap the bun. And we're keeping it low in the back because remember, we're going for evening style. Now, this style is perfect, okay, for an evening event with a middle part. And once you've got it twisted, you're going to be taking a hair tie and you're just going to, I got a black one preferably, and you're just going to be putting it around the bun. And of course, you know, I got to spray them in place, those edges or those hairs around the ears. You want to spray it in place. And she popping. She is popping. So one thing that I forgot to do with my eye makeup was do the bottom waterline of my eye, and I usually tend to forget to do that when doing my eye makeup. Hey, I'm human. So going in now, and I'm using this Morphe brush. This brush is real small for you to actually get in between the crease of your eye, but I tend to use it for my bottom waterline. And so I'm using this teal shadow from Juvia's Place. Thank you.
right, beauties, this completes this look. Please like, comment, and subscribe below.